What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create realistic metallic materials in V-Ray for SketchUp. Let's get started. So in this video, I will cover two different workflows for creating metallic materials. The first one is the specular or standard workflow using the generic material. And the second one is the metalness workflow using the new metallic material in V-Ray Next. First, I'm going to go to polygon.com and download a free metal material. I will leave the links in the description box below so you can download it and follow along with the tutorial. I'm going to choose this material here. If you click here, you can see the two workflows I mentioned earlier, specular and metalness. I will download both of these sets of maps at 3K resolution. After you have downloaded the maps, you can look at the names of the files to see what type of maps they are. With a quick look at the maps, you can see that the metalness workflow doesn't include the reflection and glossiness maps, but instead, it includes the metalness and roughness maps. Now, let's start with the specular workflow. First, create a generic material. Now, click here to open up the advanced parameters. Then let's start importing our maps. If you are new to creating materials, then watch this previous video, where I explained the functions of the basic texture maps. Now, let's load in the diffuse map by clicking this button here and choose bitmap. From there, just select your diffuse or color map. Then I can use the paint bucket tool and apply the material to our model. The UV mapping is a little off, so to fix it, I can use one of these V-Ray UV tools here. Now I'm going to use the interactive render button to test render it. As you can see, it does not look anything like the preview from the website. So let's add another map. We will add the reflection map next. Similar to before, just click this button to add a bitmap and load in the reflection map. The reflection map is loaded, but it doesn't look very good. To fix it, click here to turn off Fresnel. And boom, it looks better now. Next is glossiness. When loading this map, you need to change the color space from screen space to rendering space to have a more accurate material. Before loading the normal map, I'm going to zoom in a bit so you can see it easier. I'm also going to use the region render tool to only render half of the image so we can compare the before and after. Now let's go down here to bump and normal mapping and turn it on. Then click here to load in the normal map. This material came with two normal maps, a standard one and a 16-bit one, which is higher quality. I'll just use the standard one for now. For the normal map, you also need to change the color space to rendering space linear. And also, you need to change the map mode from bump map to normal map. Remember that if you're using the interactive render when loading a new map, sometimes you have to restart the render to make it look correct. Now you can start to see some details on the material. You can also change the intensity here if needed. This is probably too much, so I would change it back to 1. Finally, let's go down here and load in the displacement map. There are also two displacement maps. I'll load in the standard one. I'm going to restart the render to make it show up correctly. As you can see, the low quality displacement maps show some errors on the material. So I'll reload the map and use the higher quality 16-bit map instead. There we go. That looks a lot better now. Now I can start adjusting the intensity of the displacement if needed. I'm going to zoom back out and change the displacement to 10 so you guys can see the effect of the map. That's too much, so I'll decrease it to 0.5 for a more subtle effect. Here's another cool trick. I want this material to be more glossy, so I'm going to go to my glossiness map, right-click it, and choose Wrap In. Then choose one of the two new curves material. I'll use the spline curve. Now I can adjust the material right inside of V-Ray and make the glossiness map brighter, so that the material is more reflective. There we go, pretty cool, huh? And that's how you can create metallic materials using the specular workflow. Now let's jump into the MetaNest workflow. First, create a metallic material. Note that this is only available for V-Ray Next. Then let's load in the maps. First is the color map. I will navigate to the MetaNest folder and load in the color map. I'll also apply it to my sphere and adjust the UV texture just like before. Next is the MetaNest map, which replaces the reflection map from the specular workflow. This map also uses the linear workflow, so you need to change the color space to linear. Then there is the roughness map. When importing this map, you also need to change the color space to rendering space linear. Again, sometimes you need to restart the renderer to have it show up correctly. Finally is the normal and displacement maps, which are the same as the previous workflow. So I will load them into this material just like before. Again, I can also go back and adjust any maps I like using the wrap in feature. I will use the Bezier curve this time. Since the roughness map is basically the invert of the glossiness map, I will need to make this map darker to make the material more glossy. And there we go. That's how you can create realistic metallic materials in V-Ray for SketchUp. If you want to learn more about the MetaNest or PBR workflow, then check out this post on CAD Group's website. Also, I've created a library of materials for my members on Patreon. This library includes some useful metal materials. Each material includes a VR mat file, so just download it and load it into your model and it's ready to use. These are at 4K resolution, but you can get the 1K version for free on my website. But if you're interested in getting the high quality materials, then check out my Patreon. And that is all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.